everybody, and welcome to another video. So some of you may know I have a couple of 3D printers which I use to make a variety of my own products. In this case, I happen to order a 2.85 size filament for a printer that typically takes 1.75. At the time, I still hadn't added a V6 nozzle and had already installed TMC2208 stepper motor drivers and really couldn't find any tutorials on doing this mod. So I decided to see just how difficult the process would be and record the results. If you do this yourself, please keep in mind that I do not take any responsibility for any damages that may occur as a result to doing this modification, so do this at your own risk. To begin, I ordered a new hot end since I was already looking to upgrade my machine. If you're doing this modification, all you need is a replacement Bowden tube since it will fit into the existing pneumatic fitting. You're going to want to pick up a Bowden tube which is designed for 2.85 to 3 millimeters in width for the inside diameter. Since I was also ordering components from abroad, I made sure to order two along with an extra Bowden tube of the right size. I personally already own a Bowden tube cutter, however you can use standard filament cutters as long as you fix the opening after cutting the tube and make sure that your cut is straight. The first step in this project was to look into what components I would need to modify in order to keep the original functionality of the machine. In doing so, I discovered there would be two main components which would need to be changed. In this, I would need to change the filament guide, which is connected to the pneumatic fitting, and modify the housing case for the electronic components for the filament runout sensor. I will not be going over how to upgrade your hot end in today's video, but keep an eye out for future videos if you want to see that at a later date. Important to note, I did discover that this modification works best with a larger nozzle size. Therefore, you may wish to change your nozzle to 0.8, since that's the one that I tested to get good results. When installing the new Bowden tube, there's a couple of things that I learned throughout the years. First off, you want to make sure that it sticks out as straight as possible, otherwise, if you cut the tip of your filament on an angle, it could puncture the tube. I tied the tube to the wires which were already secured to the machine, and this fixed the problem. When removing the Bowden tube, you'll need to press down on the pneumatic fitting while pulling on the tube without bending it. This releases the mechanism which helps the tube from being pulled out during normal operations. When using filament which is so thick, there's a large amount of pressure that's built up in the tube which causes the tube to deform. You're better off having a little extra room in order for it to bend around corners easily. Too long, however, and you'll end up wasting a lot more filament when you're at the end of your printing spool. This filament will be quite difficult to deal with, and you should keep in mind that you will most likely be wasting the amount that you have left in your Bowden tube unless you have a filament welder connector. This is something that I've since ordered and will hopefully be testing in the future. When creating this modification, I was only able to replace the guide leading to the gears of the pneumatic fitting. The area where the filament enters into the gears was too small for FDM printing, and therefore a resin print would be required. However, most resins remain too brittle. Should I get enough requests to continue this in future, I'll create a follow-up video showing this being addressed with a resin printed part. I will need to do quite a bit of research to ensure that I use a resin which will remain flexible, so this will take quite a bit of time to achieve. The Bowden extruder, while simple in design, does have a spring mechanism that likes to shoot out, so be very careful in removing this component. I would highly recommend using some form of tape to help hold it in place while you work, or remove it entirely to keep from losing the spring. With this portion opened up, I was able to take the two components which I wanted to modify out and replace them with my own. You want to keep these parts in a safe place should you need to switch back in the future. I personally put these in a small transparent bag with all the original components just in case I required them. When remodeling the filament guide leading to the pneumatic fitting to the gears, I originally attempted to use a Bowden tube for this purpose. However, it created enough problems that I ended up extending the part instead. Should any of you decide to use this file, you're going to want to make sure that you sand down and clean up the printed replacement as much as possible to help reduce any friction that may occur. When reinstalling the pneumatic fitting, it's important to make sure that the Bowden tube is cut flat and you take your filament cutter to slightly widen its entry point. This will help ensure that it doesn't get pushed back into the machine and that the filament doesn't get caught on its edges. When cutting Bowden tubes, this is a simple trick that will help remove any pleats if you're using filament cutters. With this portion complete, I was then able to begin working on the filament sensor modification. In order to do so, I had to remove the original sensor from its plastic housing to see which portions I would need to modify. In this case, I wanted to keep the pre-existing parts so that I would be able to transition back if needed. What this meant is that I needed to create and new housing to fit all the original functionality while accounting for some of the size differences. With the portion for the circuit board completed, I then changed the filament section to accommodate the new filament size. I also included the original mounting hole so I could still attach it to the frame of the machine with a longer screw. This is the final model I ended up using in the end. With all of the new components installed, it was then time to level the bed, which in my case was pretty close and only required some minor tweaks to get it working. Then came the part of changing my print settings until I had something which was closer to what I had originally had. Now keep in mind that this is a larger nozzle size and therefore it isn't really designed to get details. It's best suited for larger prints that you don't want to take too long. So, in my case, I use this machine to create tools and rigs for my internal manufacturing processes. If you plan to sand and finish pieces anyways, then this will still work, but you may want to print at a lower height and seal the part with some form of epoxy-based putty so that it doesn't take as long to finish. So in the end, was this mod worth doing? Well, for most of you, it probably isn't. Unless you happen to have a lot of filament that's in the wrong size, then you might want to look into doing this. However, there's quite a few issues which could arise. First off, this filament is far more brittle since it has a much larger diameter, so trying to get it to print without interruptions can be a challenge. Secondly, you'll want to see if you can even print the higher temperatures that will be needed. In my case, I had to increase it by over 15 degrees Celsius to get completed prints. Anything less than the filament was too prone to clogging within the nozzle, and the extra pressure also caused the filament to break more often. Another important thing to note is that you'll have to work with your flow compensation to get it perfect. Otherwise, you'll have issues with how it comes out of the nozzle. Removing clogs was often tedious at best, since the method I found was to remove the Bowden tube entirely and then do a cold pull to remove any residue. I believe that this mod is best suited for filaments which is less brittle but flexible, since this will be less likely to break or bend within the Bowden tube. So if any of you attempt this at home, I'd be interested in hearing what you have to say about this mod in the future. If you liked this video, please feel free to subscribe, and should you wish to support more content like this, you can do so by visiting my online shop, which is in the description below. For those of you who may not know, I do live streams twice a week on Twitch, so make sure to keep an eye out for those if you're interested. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.